Hey, hey, this is Smiles here with another classic game review. Today, let's take a look back at Diddy Kong Racing. DKO is developed by Rare and originally released for the Nintendo 64 back in 1997. Since then, DKO was remade for the Nintendo DS in 2007. As evident by the title, Diddy Kong Racing is a racing game similar to Mario Kart. However, Diddy Kong Racing gives you the choice of three vehicles to race with. Players can choose to race in either a plane, a car, or a hovercraft. Each vehicle has its own advantages and disadvantages. For instance, the hovercraft has terrible handling on land, but is perfect to cut through water. The inclusion of additional vehicles adds a level of variation not normally seen in racing games. To say that Diddy Kong Racing is just a clone of Mario Kart is a huge mistake. In reality, Diddy Kong Racing is a fusion between Mario Kart and Super Mario 64. In Adventure Mode, you'll find yourself on an island that is completely explorable like Peach's Castle. With the aid of Dodge, the Indian elephant, you race around the hubroard and collect the magical balloons in an attempt to thwart the evil Whizpig's plans. As you finish first in track races, you can challenge the boss of each area to a race. The bosses are no pushover, and quite frankly, are fairly tough. After defeating them, you are given the chance to complete in the Silver Coin Challenge, which requires you to complete every track in first place while collecting all the silver coins. After that, you challenge the bosses again, who are much tougher this time around. Each area also contains a secret key you need to find in order to compete in battle stages. Adventure Mode is chock full of secrets, including trophy races, Todd races, and hidden balloons around the island. As if that wasn't enough, Rare was kind enough to allow co-op mode. With the in-game code Joint Venture, you can even play Adventure Mode with a friend. Adventure Mode and Diddy Kong Racing delivers an enjoyable single-player experience. What makes this game charming are the characters. Diddy Kong Racing allows players to choose from 10 different characters, including Banjo from Banjo-Kazooie and Conker from Conker's Bad Fur Day. Diddy Kong Racing was partially used to advertise future Rare games so players would recognize the characters when they debuted in their own series. While Diddy Kong Racing gives players a variety of characters to choose from, the racers are anything but balanced. Characters with high acceleration like Pipsy and Tip Top dominate first place, while slow characters like Banjo and Crunch will be left in the dust. The use of items in Diddy Kong Racing is unique among racing games. When you run into a colored balloon, you get an item. However, unlike item blocks, the type of item is not determined by what place you're in, but rather what color balloon you run into. Items can be further upgraded if you run into two balloons of the same item. However, running into a different balloon would change your item and get rid of your upgrade. Because the same balloons are not usually next to each other, upgrading items during a race isn't the best idea. Diddy Kong Racing also includes zippers. Zippers are located around the track to help you get a boost when you need it most. To make your vehicle go even faster, you can collect the bananas scattered around the track. Bananas increase your top speed and acceleration. As with most Rare games at the time, Diddy Kong's racing design is well done. For an N64 game, the graphics are beautiful. Each track offers breathtaking scenery that you can literally get lost in. You can forget about the race entirely and just roam around the track. David Wise, the in-house composer for Rare, really outdid himself with the soundtrack. Besides the usual toe-tapping good beats, David Wise utilized the N64 cartridge format to change the mood mid-race. While the music's tempo and tune were kept consistent, the instruments were changed without interruption to create a sudden change in mood. This feature was most evident on the character select screen in Hub World, and would later be used in future Rare games like Banjo-Kazooie. Diddy Kong Racing was visually stunning for its time, and its top-notch design made this game that much more enjoyable to play. Being the first game I owned for the N64, I have many fond memories of Diddy Kong Racing. Back in the 90s, Rare was a highly respected video game developer, and Diddy Kong Racing only proved that fans and critics alike loved the third-party developer. The characters and items prevented from being a seriously competitive game. However, the inclusion of an expansive single-player mode and unique gameplay mechanics like vehicle choices set it apart from generic racing games. With a beautiful design and high replay value, it's always a joy to revisit this classic. Diddy Kong Racing will always hold a place in my heart and be my go-to game for the Nintendo 64.
This is for you.